G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Today we've got a bit of a special one today. I don't think I've done a review on a Masterbox set before. Thought we'd have a quick look at this one. Interesting domestic animals. Now, this one here is, I'm guessing it's a cow of some description, or two cows, something like that. Is that a dairy cow? Is that a bull? And this is one of the, I think this is an American dog or something like that. I have sort of dogs in America that look like this, I think. So they've got all types of pit bulls and stuff like that over there. So, we'll have a look at this one as well. Interesting domestic animals. Now, look, when it comes to my mind, look, I probably wouldn't, you know, I mean, obviously, you know, we have T-Rexes and, you know, other sort of dinosaurs and stuff like that and stuff in the ocean. But, you know, domestic animals, you know, I probably wouldn't have called this domestic animals. Except for this dog from the States. But anyway, let's have a look inside. Anyway, no, we won't. There's the number down there, if you're looking for it. And on the back, these sort of dogs vary in colour. And you've got these sort of cows as well that can only be painted, apparently, in Vallejo colours. Apparently, if you paint them in other colours, they sort of, the strips off and falls off. So it can only be in Vallejo colours for these domestic animals. Let's have a look at this. Now, obviously, we're going to have to do a bit of a close-up because at the moment, most of the animals look like they should be on a barbecue. You know what I mean? Oh, God, let's get a bit closer. Well, I don't know if you can see that, but this here almost looks like a little bit of fur. You know, a bit of hair, if you like. And you can see some, I'm guessing, near the ribs coming through. That surprised me, but, you know, it's so fine. I just think once you paint that, it's probably not going to come through. It's just so fine. I'm going to try and get a bit closer. Look, that is amazing. I've got to say, that is amazing. It's just so fine. I just think, let's say if you went and slapped a, you know, just got your Tamiya paint and slapped that over the top of this. I don't think you'd actually see that. It's just so fine. But that is amazing. There's not a lot of things in 1/35 scale that have impressed me in a while. I mean, obviously, you know, because you get used to everything, but that is insane. Wow. I wasn't expecting that. I was not expecting that. I mean, it's just a shame. I keep on saying it, I know, but I mean, look at this dog here. On the barbecue again, the Barbie, you know. And what, look at this again. The only thing with these that obviously are going to be the problem is you've got the, what we like to call here in Australia, the arse crack. And the problem with this arse crack is it goes around the whole body. So you've basically got a 360 degree arse crack, which is a bit of a problem. So you're going to have to, you know, clean that up. Because, you know, with this fine, you know, whatever you want to call it, hair. Yeah, it's a shame that you're going to get this big ass crack all the way around it. But other than that, I mean, yeah, beautiful work on these. Look, I mean, not that. I mean, you can tell that one, but I mean, look at that. I'm sorry, guys, but that really, really does amaze me. It's very hard to show you the heads here, guys. It's, for some reason, my camera just doesn't want to zoom in that. It's about as close as I can get. And obviously, if it's on the angle, it's a bit hard to show you. Like, when I go up like that, it just gets out of focus, which is a bit annoying. The head there. Oh, it's very hard to see. This is not working out in this one, guys. I apologise. And there's the animal's tail. There's the tail. And there looks like a... Is that a chest hugger from Aliens? Or no, that's its ear. Oh, that's its ears and its horns. That's its ears and horns, yep. And what is that? That's another part there. And look, I've got to say... That head is nice. The head, the eyes, you know, look at it sticking out like that. the eyes. A bit of more of a close-up of the fur on the dog. There's some funny breeds in America. And what's this part here? Is it like a gladiator's sort of helmet or something like that? The old gladiators used to wear? Must be like some sort of cow gladiator or something. Look, it's an interesting set. Probably all up, I'd probably say, you know, it's done really nicely. The textures, I mean, if you just did a light wash over these things, but of course you'd probably have to prime it first to show all that sort of nice hair. It'd probably be quite nice. And, you know, remember some of the old Verlinden dioramas used to have some sort of animal in them? You know, just one animal in a paddock. Some guy was cooking eggs, I think, beside some sort of road in a paddock. If you remember that one, let me know. But... not too bad, not too bad. So there you have the domestic animals. And look, I'm going to say they actually look quite nicely. The only thing is, obviously, is you get the big ass crack that goes from here all the way around the whole animal. So you're going to have to putty all that up all the way around. And then I think that's why the gladiator's helmet there. It's sort of stuck on there, stuck up upside down on this sort of creature here. But other than that, I actually think it's quite a nice set. You know, it's roughly around, you know, 15 Australian dollars. So that's about probably, you know, $2.50 US, $3 US, the way the Australian dollar is these days, or just always is really. So I've got to say, I like it. I like it. If you're looking for a set, you know, you don't want to go and buy, you know, spend a fortune on a resin one or something like that. You know, this is, and you get three in this set rather than, you know, just one resin dog or whatever. It's not a bad set. I quite like it. Anyway, guys, that's just a quick one. Might do some cats next, or some ducks or something like that, and maybe some piggies. So stay tuned for that one. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.